Welcome to lecture 6 on mechanisms. So previously we have discussed about quick return motion mechanisms, straight line mechanisms and the intermittent motion mechanisms. Right now let us take exclusive mechanism wherein we need to apply only small amount of forces to create larger magnitude of forces, and such a mechanism is called as a toggle mechanism. Let us quickly go through the animation, right, which gives us a hint of what the mechanism is actually about. So if you look into the constructional details of the mechanism, we have a crank in the form of pink color, and it is connected to two links, right, and a orange block, and the yellow block looks stationary, right? So the main application of this kind of a mechanism is to make sure that we are going to apply small amount of forces at the input, and orange block can be considered as an output block here, where the amount of forces that we create will be as large as infinity. And such a mechanism we call it as a toggle mechanism. Let us go through, we will come back to this animation again. So let us go to the construction and understand the working of the toggle mechanism, right? And let us go through why, right, we can create infinite amount of forces at the output, right? So this is how the construction of a toggle mechanism looks like. So if you look here, we have link number one, which is fixed, which is connected to link number two, which is nothing but a crank. Right, crank is a rotating element which I can rotate by connecting it to any motor. Motor is capable of rotating continuously, which also makes the crank to rotate continuously. Right, so the crank is connected to the two links 4 and 5, right, through the link number 3, right, and the link number 3 connects to 4 and 5 through the point C, right. So now link 4, right, can oscillate, right, with respect to point A. Right? And the angle varies, and the inclination of the four with respect to horizontal can be called as alpha. And similarly, on the other end, we have link number 5, and it is connected to a slider which can move back and forth. Right. Similarly, inclination of the link 5 with respect to the horizontal is called as alpha. Right. Whatever the force that is going to be created, right now you can observe there are two points D and D1. Right now we went into the constructional details. Let us see how the mechanism is going to work in nature. Right. So now we have defined various points. So point A is the point where 4 gets connected to the fixed point. Point B is nothing but the slider. Point C is where 4 and 5 are held together. Point D is where 2 and 3 are held together. And point E is where the link number 2, that is crank, is connected to the support. Now let me assume that the crank rotates in the clockwise direction, and currently it is at point D. Now when the crank begins to move from point D to point D1, right, let me say that that angle is around 60 degrees, it is at D, it wants to come to D1, right? So now at point C, right, they begin to move downwards, right, and the angle alpha keeps decreasing. The angle alpha does not increase as D moves from D1. As it comes closer to D1, point C keeps going downwards, angle alpha keeps decreasing, right, and link 4 and 5, they tend or they try to become collinear, or they try to become a straight line, right? That is where the application of the toggle mechanism comes into play. Now on the other side, connected to the slider, we have placed a rock. My objective is that by the simple rotation of a crank, I should be able to crush the stone or the rock that is placed on the left hand side with respect to the slider, right? So now what happens is, right, as D tends to move towards D1, C starts moving downwards, angle alpha keeps decreasing. At a moment when 4 and 5, they become collinear, angle alpha becomes 0, and the amount of force that is applied from the crank gets multiplied by a large extent, that the resistance offered by the rock or the stone is considered as R, and the force applied is considered as F. The force applied becomes such a big quantity that the resistance will become only a small number, and the stone or the rock gets crushed in no time. That is how the toggle mechanism is going to work. Let's understand the mathematics behind it by taking the same or carrying the same diagram to the next slide. I have carried forward the same diagram to the next slide here. Right. So now let us understand what exactly is, now let us try to understand this with respect to link number 5. Right. Now this is where angle alpha is defined. I try to close this and I try to form a triangle. Let me call this point something as right? We see the letter that we have not considered, let me call it as O. So now we have a triangle BOC. So let me say that I am going to form a triangle BOC, and I want you to define what is tan alpha, right? So if I want to define tan alpha, tan is nothing but opposite divided by adjacent for the angle. So this will be the opposite side, right? And this will be the adjacent side, right? And tan is nothing but opposite divided by adjacent. What do we have on the opposite side? I need to consider only the forces and the corresponding reaction, right? Along the vertical axis, what I have is force that is applied from the movement of the crank or by the momentum of the crank, right? So when it comes to point C, the force gets split into two directions, one along 4 and one along 5, right? Let me assume that the force F splits equally at point C. Half of the force is available to link number 5 and half of the force is available to link number 4. Now my consideration is only towards link number 5. So let me assume that half of the force is available at the opposite side, and the adjacent side we have the resistance that is offered by the stone, right? So that will be existing along the horizontal line, and that is what we have considered here. So what is F here? F is can be considered as analogous to force. It can be input torque or the effort applied from the crank. That is how I can consider F as. R is nothing but the reaction offered by the object that I want to crush or break into pieces. Alpha is nothing but the inclination of the link 4 as well as link 5 with respect to the horizontal or with respect to the ground. Now this equation what we have written, tan alpha is equal to F by 2 divided by R, can be further simplified as F is equal to 2R tan alpha. Now this observing this equation lets us know how the toggle mechanism begins to work. Now we know that tan 0 degree, right, is equal to 0. We know this, right? So tan 1, tan 0.5, tan 2, they will be close to 0, right? Something like 0.01, 0.1, etc. Right? So now I know that 2R resistance will be more, and F is the effort required, right? And resistance will be a high number, right? And as the angle alpha keeps decreasing, the value of the tan alpha will be considerably low. It will be something like 0.01, 0.02. So the entire right hand side will be as low as possible, which indicates that the effort that is required to overcome the resistance offered by a huge object will be as less as possible. That indicates that for small angles of alpha, the effort that is required will be much smaller than the large resistance that is offered for it to break. So that within no time, the toggle mechanism can break any object that is kept in the purview. And one thing that we have to consider is the entire thing happens by a small movement of the slider. Slider does not move by a large amount. There will be only small movement of the slider. And with respect to that small movement of the slider, we can break huge objects. Right? And we will explore what exactly happens when alpha becomes equal to 0, or when alpha exactly tends to 0. When alpha tends to 0, we know that tan alpha tends to 0, and when alpha becomes 0, right, tan alpha becomes 0 and the entire right hand side becomes equal to 0, 2R tan alpha, it becomes 0. That indicates that the force or the effort required to break will be equal to 0. Right? So the position that occurs when alpha is equal to 0 is called as the toggle position, and we say that at that position when alpha tends to become 0, we say that the mechanical advantage tends to infinity, or the mechanical advantage will be infinity at the toggle position as the force required becomes 0 and resistance reduces to 0. Literally, virtually, I can break the object without applying any force. Though it is theoretical, practically not possible, it only lets us know the importance and the power of the toggle mechanism. That's what the alpha tends to 0 indicate. So when alpha tends to 0, we call the corresponding position as toggle position, and mechanical advantage theoretically will be infinity. That means that without the application of any force, I can break any object. What is the exact purpose, right? We can obtain large force amplification with the application of small amount of force and effort, right? What are the application in the sheet metal punching or stone crushing machine, and also in the toggle clamps, right? Those are the few applications where this toggle mechanism or the principle of the toggle mechanism can be applied, right? So we can go into a small video and see how exactly the toggle mechanism is going to work here. You can just appreciate, right? So we have to observe that the movement of the slider will be as low as possible. It moves only by a small amount. So this is just a simulation that has been done, right? So this is how the actual toggle mechanism looks like. So this will be the crank. This will be one of the link, that is a link 4, which is fixed. This will be link 3, which is pivoted at point, and this will be the crank number 2. This will be link 5, and this will be the slider. You can place the object in this gap. So with a small application, with a small rotation of the crank by your hand, you can break or you can shatter the stone into pieces, right? So this is the application of the same with respect to representation of the forces. Right, this is another application. It is called as a jaw crusher, wherein you can pour the stone from the top, and we can see that they are crushed in no time, right? And we have to observe that the movement of this jaw is as small as possible. Slider moves only by a small amount, and you can crush them into pieces, right? So one more application is in the stone crusher. We can just go through this video, right? So we can observe that the stones are being put and they are being crushed in no time, right? So how exactly happens? So you can look into the top view here. So it moves only by a small amount, the slider, right, or the jaw moves only by a small amount, and whatever the stones that they are put are crushed in no time, right? Because when alpha tends to zero and when alpha becomes smaller and smaller, the mechanical advantage or the force or the effort becomes or amplified, will get amplified by a large quantity. That is how we can explain the phenomenon of a jaw crusher, right? So another application of the toggle mechanism is in the toggle clamps. Just observe this carefully. I want to hold an object with the application of a small amount of force. Here he is applying a very small amount of force and it is struck, right? You cannot move it, right? So that is called as a toggle clamp, right? So it holds, right? You are going to apply only small amount of force. It gets magnified and holds at a higher magnitude, so that it can be used as a jig or fixture or whatsoever for the machining operations, right? So toggle clamps are available in two varieties. One, it can be vertical or it can be horizontal, as seen in the video, right? So this was all about the toggle position, which we can use to amplify, right, the small amount of forces into a bigger amount of forces, and the resistance becomes smaller compared to the force that we have applied, so that we can overcome the resistance with only small amount of forces. That is what the toggle mechanism is all about, right? So this ends the lecture number 6. Thank you.